Hey guys, it's Emil. In this video, I want to talk about something I did during my second Kickstarter campaign. In my update, I had something called missions or a call to action. It's basically where I wanted my backers to go and help me promote or in some way create some buzz around my game or my campaign. And that was something I hatched like halfway through the campaign, so I didn't use it to its full potential, but I will just jump into it and have a look at some of my missions I did, and then I will give you my pointers afterwards. So let's have a look here. The first mission was in my 18th update, which is definitely too late, but it was just a concept I came up with, so I just had to roll with it from there. You can see here, it's my 18th update. And there were some things, and definitely too much text, and blah, blah, blah. My first mission here, that was to thumb up three pictures on BoardGameGeek. So people could go into BoardGameGeek here, and most of your backers, if you're doing board games, will probably have an account here. And as you can see, it had a fairly good result on the pictures, which of course makes the pictures climb further up on the hotness, and yeah. That just makes it possible that that other people will spot the pictures as well and figure out what the game is all about. So that's the first mission I did, and it was fairly simple for a lot of backers. My second mission here is start to get a bit more advanced, and I will definitely not recommend this. You can see there were three pictures again, just links right away to, you know, you have to make it very, very simple for people to actually do and to share. And that's where this one, the second part of the mission, fails a bit, because it's posting a screenshot or doing something with an avatar or wallpaper and put it on our Facebook page. And even though there were a couple of people doing it, it's not something that most people want to trouble themselves with. So I cannot recommend doing something that is not this advanced, but just something that you have to spend more time on. It's definitely better with something where it's basically two clicks. So the fifth one here, a fifth mission, I had again some pictures. I really tried to get the ball rolling with the pictures on BoardGameGeek. And then I asked for people to add Burning Suns to the Dice Towers People Choice Award, or whatever it's called. And again, it requires a subscription, which means that not many people will do it, because it takes up more time and can actually be a bit annoying for some. So not recommending this kind of call to action. And here again, the eighth mission here, and I called them something different and tried to make them a bit thematic. Yeah, you could definitely do something like that and you know, get people really involved in also the theme of both the game and the campaign. And these were not as easy to actually track. It's where I want people to share something, the kick track data, and get some pointers for a geek list and stuff. It's very hard to actually track how effective it is. Where the first mission here is very easy to see how many actually acted on it, and it was a fair amount of people who actually went and voted for my pictures. So that's a way you can engage your backers and make them help you climb up the BoardGameGeek ladders, whatever it's on the hotness list out here, or it's the pictures hotness thing. which we find here. You can look at pictures which are hot at the moment that gets a lot of thumbs up. So here your pictures will climb up if they reach a critical mass. Okay, to sum it up, I would definitely say you should only do one type of mission or action per update, or maybe every second update, depending on how your baggers react to it and how much they commit to it. And you should focus the actions on specific topics or specific aspects. That could be like doing thumbs up on pictures, or you know, something on your Facebook page or Twitter, whatever, Reddit. The thing is, you want to focus all your effort and not spread it thin. So don't have several actions, that one is a picture and one is a Reddit comment, and you know, keep it focused to maximize the effect, definitely. And you have to keep it simple and easy to do. I definitely jumped overboard on some of the missions, and the best effect was definitely from the missions where it was very simple, and basically here it's two clicks. So that is something you can definitely do. So that was it for me this time. So have a great day, and thank you for watching.